Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. On this video, we do the following six problems. All right, we're going to learn how to subtract a fraction or a mixed number from a whole number. So first, you have to remember how to change a whole number to a fraction and see my video on that if you're not sure how to do that. But here's a quick review. Let's say you've got the number 8 and you want to write it as a fraction. There's two ways of doing it. One way is to begin by just writing it as 8 over 1 and then multiplying it by something, right? To make an equivalent fraction with a denominator that you want. So let's say you wanted a denominator of 5. So what would you multiply 1 times to get 5? You'd have 1 times 5, and whatever you multiply the denominator by, you multiply the numerator by, so that you're just taking that number 8 and multiplying by 1, so your new numerator is 40. So that's a quick review of how to write the number 8 as a fraction with a denominator of 5. The other way of doing it is, say if I want to write 8 with a denominator of 5, you have to figure out what goes up in the numerator. It's just going to be 5 times 8. And then make sure that your answer makes sense. Is 40 divided by 5 the same as 8? Yes, it is. Okay, so that's a little quick review of how to write a whole number as a fraction that has a certain denominator. All right, so now let's take a problem using this idea. Let's take 8 minus, and let's first just subtract a fraction. So let's do 8 minus 5/6. All right, there's a couple ways of doing this. One way is thinking, well, 8 is really the same thing as 7 plus 1. So I could think of that as 7, right? 8 is the same thing as 7, but I could think of it as 7 plus 1. Right? And 7 plus 1, well, instead of writing 1, how about if I write it with the same denominator as I have for the 5/6? So I want to write the number 1 as 6/6. So this becomes 7 and 6/6 minus 5/6. Now look at this carefully. See if that makes sense to you. 8 is the same thing as 7 and 6/6, because that's the same thing as 7 plus 1. So now how am I going to do this? I got 7 and 6/6 minus 5/6. Well, I still have 7. And then I've just got to go 6/6 minus 5/6, which is 1/6. So that's one way of doing it. Right, another way of doing it is just changing the 8 to a fraction right off the bat. So 5/6 I'm going to leave as is, but 8, how could I write that as something over 6? Using this little idea up here, I would multiply 8 times 6, 48. So now if you do it this way, you might have bigger numbers to subtract, but a lot of people find this easier than this kind of borrowing idea, rewriting 7, I mean, rewriting 8 as 7 and 6, 6. So now what do I have? Well, I've got the denominator of 6, and then 48 minus 5 is 43. And that's it. That's the correct answer, by the way. Just like this is a correct answer. Because 1 is just written as an improper fraction, 46, 43 over 6, and the other one's written as a mixed number. But they're exactly the same thing. So I've taken a whole number, 8, and subtracted a fraction from it. All right, let's have you try one. How about 6 minus 3/4? Now, I've shown you two ways to do it. It really doesn't matter which way you do it, but you know, usually people find one way easier for them over a different way, so that's really up to you. So try this on your own by putting the video on pause. Okay, one method is to just change both of them to just fractions. So I'd have to change 6 to a fraction, right? So I'm going to do it as fourths, so I have the same denominators I have over here. And what would go in the numerator there? 24, because 24 divided by 4 is 6, right? So then I have a common denominator, and I just have to subtract the numerators. 24 minus 3 is 21. Now you could do this In a vertical fashion, by the way, it doesn't really matter. Some people like to subtract going up and down, and then you would just change this to 24 fourths minus 3 fourths. Again, options. So people say, why do you show me more than one way? Just show me one way. And it's like, well, it's because there isn't one easiest way for everybody. All right, now, what's the other method we use for 6 minus 3 fourths? Well, I could take 6, and remember, 6 is the same thing as 5 plus 1. So I'm going to write that 5, and I'm going to write the 1 as 4 fourths, because I want to have the same denominator as I have for the other fraction, which is the 3 fourths. So I've got 5 and 4 fourths minus 3 fourths. Okay, so I still have 5 and 1 fourth. This time the answer is coming up as a mixed number because of writing this as a mixed number still. But again, it's the same thing as 21 fourths. And also, this could have been written in vertical format as well. 5 and 4 fourths minus 3 fourths. And you still would have gotten the 5 and 1 fourth for your answer. Some people can do this in their head. They think, well, 6 minus 3 fourths. Well, one way of thinking about subtraction is, what do you add to 3 fourths to get 6? And if I added 1 fourth to 3 fourths, I would have 1, right? So if I add a fourth and then 5 more, get me 6. That's okay. Hey, if you get the right answer and it makes sense to you, that works, right? If not, go ahead and use the method I just showed you. All right, let's try a different one now. This time I'm subtracting a mixed number from a whole number. And I'm doing it in vertical form. It's usually easier for most people. Okay, so if I could do 8 minus 2 and then 0 minus 4 sevenths, but there's a problem here. 0 minus 4 sevenths, you're going to get a negative number. So let's not go there, although there is a way of doing that as well. How about we just change both of these to fractions? So this is one method, change both of them to fractions, having the same denominator. Since the 2 and 4 sevenths is the one with the denominator, we'll make that sevenths, and then we need to also make 8 in terms of sevenths. So what does that give me? Well, in the top, how do I change the whole number 8 to a fraction with 7? I got to do 7 times 8 for my numerator. That's 56. All right. 2 and 4 sevenths. How do I change that to an improper fraction? 7 times 2 is 14, plus 4 is 18. And now I could subtract. So I'm going to have sevenths, and I've got to do 56 minus 18. So that's 38 sevenths. Or if you change it to a mixed number, that's going to be, let's see, 5 and 3/7. All right, so that's by just changing each of them to improper fractions. Now, some people, what I just said a minute ago, can do this in their head. They're going to say, well, what do I have to add to 2 and 4/7 to get back up to 8? Well, if I add 3/7, that gives me 1, right? Right? Plus I have 2 more already. So if I add all this together, so it gives me 1 plus 3 more, and then 5 more will get you back up to 8. That's kind of a way of doing it in your head, reasoning it out a little bit differently. Just wanted to show you that that is a perfectly okay way to get the answer. Okay, now the other way of doing it is with the borrowing technique, 8 and 4, 8 minus 2 and 4 sevenths. All right, we're going to borrow from the 8 and make it 1. So it's 7 plus 1. Think of it as 7 plus 1. So now I have 7, and I want to write the 1 as having as a fraction with the same denominator I have down here, which will be sevenths. Oops, what happened here? Sorry. Let's get that back to 7. Okay. So I'm going to have 7 and what? 7/7, right? Because I want to have the same denominator. Minus 2 and 4/7. So I can now do the 7 minus 2, which is 5, And 7/7 minus 4/7 is 3/7. And we get it again. So as you can see, there's just different ways to do it, but you don't need to know how to do it all of the different ways. What you have to do is try at least one problem, be able to get it right, use one method, and if you want, stick with that method. This first method here, where you change both to improper fractions, I think more people like doing it that way. Okay, but it depends on the person. Okay, here's one for you to try. How about 9 minus 3 1/8? Try any method you want. See if you can get the right answer. Okay, hopefully you put the video on pause and now you're ready to go. All right, first of all, I'm just going to show you the way of reasoning it out. What do I have to add to 1/8 to get 1? I'd need 7/8 more. So that adds up to 1 so far. Plus 3 more is 4. Plus what'll give you 9? 5. All right, so the answer is going to be 5 7/8. So if you got 5 7/8 using some method, that's the correct answer. If you had written it as a mixed number. Okay, let's do it by changing each to improper fractions. So when you write a whole number as a fraction, you're writing it as an improper fraction. So what'll go up in the numerator here? It's going to be 8 times 9. 72. And then we have 8 times 3 is 24 plus 1 is 25. And now I could subtract. And let's see, I think that's 47/8. Okay, and then the question is are these the same? And yes, they are. If you change 5 7/8 to an improper fraction, you would get 47/8. And if you change 47/8 to a mixed number, you'd have 5 7/8. So let's say I just showed you two ways to do it. And of course, you could do the borrowing method just for fun, those of you who like that way. You would borrow and add one. Now, to take less room, how about instead of writing one, we just write what the improper fraction is going to be. We want to write it in eighths, so it'll be 8/8. So that would give me 8 minus 3 is 5. And 8/8 minus 1/8 is 7/8. Okay, there we go again. So sort of showed you a few ways that you might get the answer. And all of these are correct. It doesn't matter if you write it as 5 7/8 or 47/8. It doesn't matter if you reason out the answer, if you change to improper fractions and subtract, or if you use borrowing, get a common denominator. We're all ending up at the same place. The answer is 5 7/8. Here are three problems for you to try. So let's put the video on pause and try these three problems using any method. Okay, you back? All right, so I'm just going to write the answers, not show all the work this time because there's, of course, three or four different ways to do it. So 7 minus 4/5 is 6 1/5 if you wrote it as a mixed number, or 30 1/5 if you wrote it as an improper fraction. 9 minus 5 2/3 is 3 1/3 if you wrote it as a mixed number, or 10/3 if you wrote it as a fraction, an improper fraction. And 6 minus 1 1/2 is 4 1/2, or 9/2. The way I did this was just by reasoning it out, by the way. I just figured out what 7 minus 4/5, I'm going to figure out what I have to add to that to get back up to 7. So that's the method I actually use, but you can do it by getting the improper, fractions, writing the whole numbers, as fractions, etc. You could do the borrowing method, or you can reason out the answer. And the way to check your answer is if you add the answer back to what you were subtracting, you should get back to the original number. So, for instance, if you add 4/5 and 6 1/5, does that add up to 7? Well, that would be 6 5/5, or 6 plus 1, which is 7. If you add 5 2/3 plus 3 1/3, you would get 8 3/3, which is 8 plus 1, adds up to 9. And 1.5 plus 4.5, same reasoning, add up to 6. So that's how you could tell you got the right answer. So it doesn't matter if you write your answer as mixed number or improper fraction, but in this case it was easier to check by taking the mixed number. Okay, keep practicing. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.